Kay that I'm working for right now. What call is the call? Nah, I'm not gonna cook, I'm not hungry. So why cook? I'm not hungry. I'll cook when mom gets home. YouTube. 1 o'clock? Okay, it's not bad. It's only 1 o'clock right now. Okay, so that's not bad. It's only 1 o'clock. Almost, and I got some time to go before I have to feed the kids.
Upon his first day of retirement, Marcus Rogers made a contract with himself. I will never again work for another man or woman.
Hungry, but I'm not hungry. I'm hungry, but I'm not hungry. Shit, let's cook in the garage.
That freedom calls. We're here to answer.
We are here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and we want our customers to know that we are in here working for them.
Top of the line talent and technology helps ensure power is on over 99% of the time. Consumers Energy, a force of change, a force for you.
Unless you've been living in a bubble these last 2 years, you've definitely heard of the world's most secretive country, North Korea. Because the country has allowed some foreign visitors to enter, and because information has been received from defectors, we've been learning some totally bizarre things about the way North Koreans are forced to live their lives in their own bubble, sheltered from the rest of the world by a controlling dictator. We feel sorry for them, which is why we think it's important for us to focus on what's really going on there. And that's what we'll look into today, in this episode of the Infographic Show, Regular Things That Are Illegal in North Korea. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell button so that you can be part of our notification squad. North Korea is so serious about controlling crime and its citizens that when various crimes are committed, not only is the assailant punished, but their entire bloodline for 3 generations too. Whole families and even entire villages have been publicly executed for the pettiest of crimes in order to teach people a lesson. If someone is lucky enough to escape from a North Korean prison camp, their whole family will be captured and brought into the camp to replace them. Let's begin with sarcasm. Some of you may have seen the 2014 comedy titled The Interview, in which Kim Jong-un had the absolute piss taken out of him. Well, apparently he wasn't too happy about that, and his regime put out terrorist threats to try to shut it down. They even allegedly hacked into Sony Pictures servers. In an attempt to avoid any further loss at his expense, the fearful dictator banned all sarcastic comments about him and North Korea. He particularly doesn't like anyone using the phrase, "It's all America's fault," or him being described as a fool who cannot see the outside world, and doing so will land you in a prison camp. Oh, and you can forget about rolling your eyes, too. Next up, mourning without meaning it. When a North Korean leader dies, it is imperative for citizens to show hysteria and intense public mourning as a sign of their admiration and worship. When Kim Jong-il died in 2011, a 100-day mourning period ensued, which saw the streets crowded with people crying and falling to their knees. Those who didn't show up to mourn faced execution, and if anyone was spotted not crying or appearing to be sad, they were taken off to a prison camp. If you think your sartorial choices couldn't possibly land you in jail, think again. You'd be hard-pressed to find someone in America that doesn't own a pair of jeans, but in North Korea, you literally won't find anyone wearing them. That's because it's illegal. To North Koreans, jeans are a symbol of their enemy, America, and the denim ban imposes their anti-West and anti-West.
done with you guys.